Welcome back. Bengals win 24-17 in the AFC wild card playoffs. Doing as at 11:57 p.m. Where to start? I don't know where to start. First thing first, give credit to the Ravens. They fought. They played well. They're a good team. Ravens are a good team. And they almost did it. So you gotta give credit to where credit's due. I know there's a lot of disrespect going on, a lot of hatred between both teams, stuff like that. Hatred is a strong word, but that's what it felt like. AFC North playoff bowl. And we got it done. We got it done. We got it done. We absolutely got it done. But let's just get to that last play, man. That last play. I'm probably gonna pop it up on the video, but how close was bro getting the cashing out ball on that Hail Mary? Jesus, man. I was absolutely crapping myself. Absolutely crapping myself. That last possession Baltimore had, I was absolutely crapping myself. I was worried. I was scared. God, I'm not gonna lie to you guys. I was absolutely scared. But we held on. Guy correct defense. Cam Sample came on. Put a lot over Hendrickson, though. He's not fully healthy. Played well. Zach Carter played well. The linebackers, shout out Logan Wilson. I am going to get to the Sam Hubbard fumble recovery for six. I will get to that. But there's so much I do have to talk about, man. Let's go ahead. And let's get into the post-game reaction. Let's get into the post-game reaction. Starting off, thought we played first quarter, thought we played very, very well. First shot was promising. We only managed to put up 3 points. Akeem Davis-Gabbert, shout to him. He's not really on defense as much because of Pratt and Wilson, but he stepped up with that pick. Huntley just, I think he just let Andrews a bit too far. That was just a miss, bro. And Akeem Davis-Gabbert picked it off. And then also, I found out a rule about a horse collar. You can't get horse collared while the quarterback is in the pocket. Because Joe Burrow got horse collared in the pocket. And also, before I even get to that, Baltimore with these little antics, these little nasty plays, Marcus Peters, man. All right. It was chippy from the get-go. And that's what I expected, and that's what I already knew. It was going to get chippy. It was going to get very, very aggressive in that first half, in that first quarter. And it showed. And it showed. But Burrow gets sacked. He got sacked 4 times for 26 yards. I will get to that. He gets horse called in the end zone, and the refs don't call it. What? But then I found out you can't get called. The quarterback can't get called for horse collar if he gets horse collar in the pocket. Doesn't make sense. Then Ja'Marr Chase scores a touchdown, make it 9. Money Mac, that's missed actually. That's missed the PAT. And then Baltimore comes right down, make it 9-7. Did what I expected Baltimore to do in 2 game. I expected Baltimore to run the ball the majority of the time in this game. You see that they ran the ball 35 times compared to 29 times. Also, gotta give credit to Tyler Huntley. He made some plays this game. Tyler Huntley made some plays this game, man. He made some plays. He made some absolute plays. Escaped the pocket, evading sacks. That one play, Tyler Linderbaum, whatever, hiked the ball, went over Huntley's head. I think he threw it to a Josh Oliver for a first down in the second half. Gotta get credit to crazy. That was pretty cool. But going back to Baltimore drive, J.K. Dobbins did score, making that 7. Solid drive. And then Hurst fumbled. I was like, oh God, I was nervous the whole game. Hurst fumble. And then, Baltimore made it 10-9 before the half. So big time stop before the half. Kind of similar to last year versus Kansas City. A big time stop before the half. Instead of making it 7, we're holding it 3. And it was 10-9 entering halftime. Second half, man, Ravens continue to run the ball. Bengals get the possession. Hayden Hurst gets stopped at the 1. I thought he did score. I like the little little gritty, but he didn't get it. Burrow sneaks it in. Higgins makes it as we go for two, makes it 17-10. And then what a route by DeMarcus Robinson made it 17-17. It was a little sluggo sling, I think it's what it's called. It's in Madden. I know what it's called. I just forgot. I think it's like it's sluggo something, sluggo seam, something like that. Eli Apple gets shaken out in boots like a stripper. May of 17-17. And then the play of the game. And probably one of the biggest plays in Bengals history. Tyler Huntley is at the goal line, reaches over. He's not even close. So I really don't understand why Tyler Huntley was talking about, you know, he was over the line, stuff like that. Bro wasn't even close. You know what I mean? He wasn't even close. The Wilson strips it out of bro's hand, right into Hubbard's hands. And he takes like 98, 99 yards for fumble six to make it 24-17, man. Also, gotta get shut to Joseph Asai. Big time plays. I think he had a sack. And I think he had a that little, you know, run, what's his name had. Huntley stopped him. But shout out to Joseph Asai, man. Big time plays when counted upon. And then the fourth quarter is very irritating because we was up 24-17. We went three and out. And then we had roughing the punter, then we go three and out again. That can't happen in the playoffs. And when the team gets your chance to score, to get another possession, you got to convert on that. I mean, thank God we did win the game, but those two possessions was really irritating because we didn't really do what we should have done. And going back to the playoffs last year, the offense struggled at times. The offense did struggle at times. So that's that. And then at the end of the game, we managed to hold on for the win, and it was stressful. And the Bengals make consecutive playoff games for the first time in team history. So overall, good win, 24-17. Now let's get into some of my thoughts and just a little quick recap. Dax Hill just struggled today. He had like two or three penalties of calling him. You know, we drafted first round, not really too concerned. Hopefully he shakes it off, gets ready for next week. But yeah, it wasn't great to see that. Logan Wilson had 10 tackles. Shout out to Logan Wilson. Absolutely shout out to Logan Wilson. I'm trying to get my notes. I'm sorry about that. What else happened? We can't run the ball. Again, the running game struggled. Again, 11 carries for what? 55? 18 carries for 51 yards just in the rushing game. Joe Mixon had 11 for 39. The running game has got to get going. And the second, in these last few games, the running game has not gotten going. And it's kind of irritating. It's very irritating, actually, because we just can't seem to run the ball right now. And Joe Burrow only going for only 290 yards. Similar to last week against Baltimore, I think he threw about, what, 212, two by 220. So, yeah, that was very, very irritating. Thought the pass rush was getting back there at times. It was just elusive by Tyler Huntley. But at the end, they get back there. But the O-line, we lost Jonah Williams on that line. Jonah Williams is going to be out. Jonah Williams did get hurt with a little knee injury. So Jackson Carmen stepped in. I thought Jackson Carmen was playing well at first, but he did have a holding penalty and a sack allowed. So it's frustrating because we've had the same O-line throughout the whole season until L. Collins gets hurt. And then Alex Kappa, he gets hurt last week against Baltimore. Now Jonah Williams is hurt. So three out of five offensive linemen are hurt. And the whole right side is new, which you kind of saw the struggles that they had tonight against that Baltimore pass rush. So, you want to start the offense, receivers. Chase had one or two drops. Not very happy about that. We're going to drops, but it is what it is. Harris, I thought he played well besides the fumble. And, you know, at the end of the day, man, we did what we needed to do. And what a first week of NFL playoffs, man. Obviously, Jacksonville coming back against Chargers. Giants win against the Vikings. I kind of already knew the Vikings weren't really it. But I was just surprised the Giants actually did it. San Fran being Seattle, kind of expected that. And then Buffalo, who we have to go to, which I will get to that right quick. So, obviously, we had the scary injury to Hamlin. Great to see him doing much better. And so now we have to go to Buffalo. Why is that not a neutral site game? Again, that doesn't even make any sense why we have to go to Buffalo, but it is what it is. I don't get that part, but we gotta go to Buffalo. So that's gonna be a heck of a game. Looking forward to it. And Bengals have advanced, man, to the what divisional round? Just taking one game at a time. Just taking one game at a time. And remember the last time we played Buffalo, the start that we had, it was 7-3. And I thought we was gonna score again before the injury. And we're gonna see, man. We're gonna see, but very much looking forward to it. Good win. Very, very good win. You guys stay safe. Enjoy the night. Hoo day. Talk to you guys later, man. Peace.